It's a great pleasure to see all of you today as we begin another very exciting academic year here at USC, a year that is full of possibilities and opportunities. Before I start, I wanted to, first of all, single out the most important person in this room, and this is Jennifer Alvarado. Jennifer has very expertly put together this event, and as she does also many events so well all the time. So thank you very much, Jennifer, for putting this together. On a more somber note, I would like to all of us to take a moment of silence in the memory of several members of our family whom we lost the last few months. Mary Frances, beloved staff at EE, our graduate student Shinran Z during the summer, Professor John Choma, Emeritus Professor Jerry Nandler, and also General Harold Green, a PhD alum from material science, who was the first United States high-ranking general to lose his life in Afghanistan. I'm also very sad to report today that Oliver Franke, professor of practice in AME, and the husband of our dear colleague Andrea Hodge, suffered a massive heart attack earlier this week and passed away yesterday. Our thoughts and prayers are with all their families. So let's please observe a moment of silence in their memory. Thank you. This year marks the 109th anniversary of the founding of the USC Viterbi School of Engineering, 109 years. Andy Viterbi received his PhD in EE at about the halfway point of our history, 52 years ago. This year also, today, marks the 10th anniversary of the transformative naming gift to the school from Andy and his wife Erna in 2004. We have grown tremendously through the years, most notably the last 10 years. But our Viterbi name and its association bridges a deep history, reaches back to the idyllic early 60s of nascent technology to today, when technology is pervasive in all aspects of our life. So in many ways, the School of Engineering has always been the Viterbi School of Engineering. It's been synonymous with the academic excellence, inventiveness, entrepreneurship, and character of its alumnus and current namesake. The number 10, the 10 years since the naming, is an irresistible number for me, and I would think for many in this audience. So let's take a moment to think of 10 accomplishments in the last 10 years of the school. I will resist from calling them top 10, all in terms of power of 10, and we're only using positive integers as powers. Those of you who will correct me at some point later on. So here we go. In this 10-year span, 10 members of our faculty were elected to the National Academy of Engineering, which is the highest honor in the engineering profession. 10 members of our faculty, of which I'm proud to say 6 women, a 60% fraction, were named to the TR35 list of the top 35 young technology innovators in the world under the age of 35. The iPodia Alliance, our imaginative global classroom initiative of joint classes across the oceans, now counts 10 members, with Qatar University having joined the alliance last spring, thus becoming the 10th iPodia member and the first in the Arabic world. 10 universities spanning 4 continents. The number of graduate applications to USC Viterbi has increased by about 10,000 since 2004, nearly a threefold increase. Our distance education network was ranked number 1 in the nation in graduate distance learning programs in technology. Remember that 1 is 10 to the power of 0. Of course, there is nothing zero about this distinction. And our games program, jointly with the School of Cinematic Arts, has also been ranked the top games program in the nation for the fifth straight year. In my estimate, in the last 10 years, USC Viterbi faculty have published more than 10,000 books, papers, and reports. 10,000 is also the number of rubber chicken dinners I have had in various events during the last 9 years as a dean. The school has renovated more than 100,000 square feet of space. About, Linda tells me that this actually figure is for the last 3 years, and I'm almost sure that we have renovated at least a third of our space by creating new and renovated space. In the last 10 years, the school has raised more than $500 million in gifts and pledges from outside donors. Now, this is not really expressing power of 10, I mean, I can make it, but I think it's pretty darn impressive. So I thought I should include it anyway. I don't have official statistics, but I would guess that this is a record sum for any engineering school in the nation. Including the Viterbi naming, I can count 10 transformative gifts given to the school in the last 10 years. Mork family, Ming Shea twice, Ken Klein, Sani Astani, Faribor's Massi, Epstein family, Airbus, USC Michelson. And in a renewed vote of confidence to the school, Andy and Erna Viterbi made last June another $10 million gift to the school to support outstanding students and faculty. This year, we will also celebrate the 10th anniversary of the founding of the Department of Astronautics, which was founded in 2004, one of the few such departments in a top research university. Perhaps we will have a starry night event to celebrate that, or a star-studded event. We look forward to launching it. Of course, those of you who follow me on Twitter know about all this already. Those who don't, it's never too late. Follow me at Dean Yortsos. I should open a quick parenthesis here. I'm either a man of contradictions or a very versatile one. I can communicate with 140 characters in Twitter or 4,000 words in the State of the School speech. Unfortunately, you have no option today other than the 4,000 words. So sit back and relax. I am tempted to extrapolate. I do want to extrapolate the last 10 years and see the next 10 years not only matching, but exceeding this in a multitude of other past accomplishments. Why I am greatly optimistic about engineering and USC Viterbi? Because in the words of the late president of the National Academy of Engineering, Chuck Vest, we live in the most exciting era for science and engineering in human history. And USC is one of the most important and exciting phases of its own history. This is a theme to which I have returned to time and again, and which drives today's world. Engineering is empowering society. We call this Engineering Plus. At USC Viterbi, we look at engineering or at technology in a much broader sense than the traditional. Here's how we think. We think of technology as taking advantage or leveraging phenomena for useful purposes. Leveraging phenomena for useful purposes. Traditionally, these phenomena we exploit as engineers are of physical, chemical, or geological nature. Semiconductors, chemical synthesis, water aquifers, oil and gas. And the resulting technology, it's what we traditionally associate with engineering, computers, airplanes, hydrocarbons. We are very much pursuing this phenomena today, and we will always do. During the last few decades, however, the rapid advances in biology have also brought us biotechnology and bioengineering. We now exploit biological phenomena with their unprecedented consequences for health and medicine, as well as for biomimetic processes to design new materials and new processes. This has brought ever closer biology, engineering, and medicine. This is the convergence we witness today. This is increasing complexity from the physical to the biological is another way of defining engineering plus. Engineering is the glue that keeps this convergence together, focused, creative, and with consequence. So as complexity increases, the phenomena or subsets of previous technologies that technology itself leverages have multiplied from the mechanical to the biological. And in this train of thought, the next step will involve even more complex systems, such as individuals, the human body as a whole, including the brain, and then societal phenomena. So I will argue that we are also witnessing, in an unprecedented fast pace, technologies which are based on leveraging societal in addition to physical, chemical, and biological phenomena. Think of the general category of social media, or what is loosely called internet companies. The corresponding convergence here brings together engineering and social sciences. These technologies also serve useful purposes, or hope they do, and they empower the individual and the society in unprecedented ways, from crowdsourcing to the Arab Spring to all other activities that we're witnessing. This enabling power of engineering is why I am so full of anticipation for the future and why USC Viterbi, which cultivates this mindset, is such an exciting place to be. It also helps to change the conversation about engineering, where we define and want to articulate engineering as there is no other profession that unleashes the spirit of innovation like engineering. Few professions turn so many ideas into so many realities. Few have such a direct and positive effect on people's everyday lives. And engineers and their imaginations will help us meet the needs of the 21st century. This is part of the National Academy movement to change the conversation about engineering. And we are very much believers in this movement. One of the most interesting books I read over the summer is The Second Machine Age by Eric Brynjolfsson and Andrew McAfee from MIT. Among the many important points they make, I like most the classification of technology. They classified it in these three categories. Exponential technologies, for example, nanotechnology or biotechnology. These are the type of technologies that require advanced PhD level research with a promise of exponential pace returns. Digital technologies, where digitization is the key enabler for everything. This is a domain of computer science, big data, informatics. It defines the digital world as the new language to interpreting, even experiencing our physical world. In a way, it's the new mathematics. And combinatorial technologies, which borrow from existing technologies to create new ones, where the main innovation is the idea and the tools to combine rather than discover specific existing technologies for a useful purposes. So this is the canvas in which we will paint and we will play: exponential, digital, combinatorial. It is our mission to develop these new technologies, whether it's the exponential, digital, or combinatorial space, for useful purposes. And these purposes will be to meet existing and new grand challenges in sustainability, security, health, and the enrichment of life. Challenges such as the NAE grand challenges, where our school is providing world-level leadership. What does it take for USC Viterbi to continue flourishing and be propelled to higher levels of excellence? I have summarized our vision in terms of four pillars. Last time I said, consider this like the Parthenon with four pillars. So you get the picture. The first pillar, attract top talent, whether students, faculty, or staff from anywhere in the world. Create the environment for them to flourish. Our second pillar, continuously keep adding value in the curriculum, our programs, and our infrastructure. The third pillar, lead globally to solve world challenges and enrich life, from sustainability to health to security to the elevation of the world's standard of living. And four, be the catalyst for the innovations that will fuel the economic growth of Southern California and by extension, the United States and the world. I will give you a brief glimpse of where we stand in these four pillars at this moment. Just like last year, our freshman class is simply superb. This year, the yield for enrollments increased by an unprecedented 25% compared to last. 31% of the entering class were university scholars. 59 are national merit scholars. 20% had perfect math scores. The average SAT this year is about 10 points higher than last year's. The power of 10 again. It has increased by 66 points since the new test was introduced back in 2006. 37% of the entering freshmen are women. This is an unprecedented number, when only 18% or so is the national average across the nation in engineering. We almost have double that percentage in our school. I'm also proud to say that the female student percentage in computer science, a notoriously underrepresented field for women, is actually 28% here at USC. Students come from 29 different countries and 35 different states, and they have incredibly diverse backgrounds and interests. Our curriculum and program innovations continue at a very rapid pace, with new minors, new programs being added or considered, from informatics and big data to new iPodia offerings. Developing skills outside the curriculum is also a key and important part of the students' experience. This year's USC Aero Design team beat 72 other teams in the nation to take first place in a national design-build fly competition in Wichita, Kansas. One of the team captains of the USC Racing Team, another student organization, Jason Zeid, was named a winner in the highly competitive Infinity Performance Engineering Academy. As a result, he has received a year-long engineering internship with Infinity Red Bull Racing, a championship Formula One team in the United Kingdom. He was one of three chosen from the United States. This year, we had a new record of master's science applicants to our school. 13,000 have applied for our master's program. Not all of them have enrolled. Just wanted to make sure to know that. High numbers help us increase our selectivity, which improves every year. Simin Mehrabani, a PhD student at USC Viterbi, and her team won the Silver Award for research at the Materials Research Society Conference in San Francisco earlier this summer. Simin has created a reliable ultraviolet sensor that detects levels of UV radiation through various environmental conditions. She credits her faculty advisor and project collaborator, Professor Andrea Armani, for much of her success. In the past recruitment cycle, we hired 11 new tenure-track faculty from over 1,600 total applicants. Among that elite group, a number are starting this fall. Maryam Sanechi, assistant professor in electrical engineering systems, coming from Cornell. Ali Abbas, professor of industrial and systems engineering, with a joint appointment in the Price School, and the new director of CREATE, our National Center for Risk and Economic Analysis of Terrorism Events, joining us from the University of Illinois at Urbana-Champaign. Adam Smith, assistant professor in civil and environmental engineering, joining us from Michigan. Rehan Kapadia from UC Berkeley, and Han Wang from MIT and IBM, new assistant professors in electrical engineering, electrophysics. These are some of the 11 that are starting this year. Some of them will start in January. As I mentioned before, earlier this year, the MIT Technology Review announced its Tier 35 list, top 35 innovators in the world under the age of 35. Among the winners are three USC faculty members who I believe are here today. Miriam Sanetti, Assistant Professor of Electrical Engineering, George Banwise, Assistant Professor of Civil and Environmental Engineering, and Megan McCain, Assistant Professor of Biomedical Engineering. This is the first time ever that three such winners were selected from USC Viterbi in the same year, among a few and select 35 such talented people worldwide. We're extremely proud of them. In other distinctions, Shanghua Tang was recently named a 2014 Simons Investigator that comes with a significant funding associated with that. Shanghua was one of only two in the area of theoretical computer science to receive this award in the nation. Costa Ciudas received the 2014 AAAR David Sinclair Award. Polroni, Jonathan Gratch, and Kevin Knight were named fellows in their societies. Mike Chen won a 2014 DARPA Young Faculty Award. Maya Matarik was named a top 10 influential female engineer by Design News. I know that because she's very influential in my office. Azad Madni received the INCOSI Lifetime Achievement Award in Systems Engineering. And just yesterday, I learned that Dan Dapkus won the prestigious John Tyndall IEEE Award, the most prestigious award in photonics. As I go through this list, I would be remiss if I did not acknowledge the very significant change in our EFC bylaws, the Engineering Faculty Council bylaws, that is effective now this year. Effective this year, we will have a representative from all our faculty, both on the tenure and the non-tenure track. I wanted to thank from this podium last year's EFC and its chair, Joe Kunz, for bringing to a successful conclusion that initiative. The Information Technology Program continues to offer new minors that have generated much interest among non-Viterbi students. This popular program has grown substantially in recent years. I'm very proud of the program and its faculty and the strong leadership provided by its director Mike Crowley. I'm not surprised by IETP's success. In this increasingly competitive and technologically oriented world, few subjects are as relevant and topical as computer science and engineering. And IETP is a key contributor, the key contributor, to the combinatorial technologies that I mentioned earlier. ISI, with the exciting leadership of Prem Natarajan, is charting a new course in its glorious history. And they have already secured some new big grants with more to follow. I am very strongly committed to its success and the launching of new ventures. And I work very closely with Prem to help raise ISI to new heights. This past June, Argus II, the artificial retina created by Marco Mayon and his colleagues, was implanted into the left eye of patient Lisa Kulik at the USC Eye Institute. Lisa was the first person west of the Mississippi to have this surgery. Until recently, she could not even walk down the sidewalk for fear of falling off. Today, after slowly losing her vision over 30 years, Lisa has some of it restored. She recently saw the moon for the first time in decades. A team led by Carl Kesselman recently received a $10 million grant from the National Institutes of Health to create a much-needed craniofacial research database. The hub would better organize data sets on development and deformities in the face and brain to give doctors, surgeons, and researchers easier access to such information. Scott Fraser, director of the USC Dornsife and Viterbi Translation Imaging Center, worked alongside Carl to secure that funding. When the USC Michelson Center for Convergent Bioscience opens, Scott will be among the first USC Viterbi faculty to call it his home. Groundbreaking for USC Michelson is set for late October next month. Professor Ted Berger and an interdisciplinary team have developed a microchip that could suppress brain seizures in people with epilepsy. This device would monitor patients and send out an electrical stimulation to calm the brain at the onset of an episode. Human clinical trials for the device could take place at the Keck School of Medicine in the very near future. Finally, last month, UAC became the home to a new hub of innovation, one of only 7 in the nation, aimed at helping high-tech startups succeed. We received a 3-year, $3.5 million grant from the National Science Foundation to create what is known as the iCore node at USC. This effort will unite USC Viterbi and USC Marshall with our partners at UCLA and Caltech. I'm extremely excited about this effort because it has the potential to place USC at the center of the emerging technology ecosystem in Southern California. Along with all other entrepreneurial and innovation activities, such as VSI Square, the Viterbi Startup Garage, and the Massey Entrepreneurship Prize competition, we're positioning USC Viterbi as a leader in the emerging tech innovation and entrepreneurial ecosystem in Southern California. It's our goal for us to become the center of that activity. Our budget this year is also strong, thanks in part to the innovation in our programs, the quality of our faculty, the strength of our board, and the strategic planning ahead of my team, specifically John O'Brien and David Murphy. So as you can see from this relatively short review, the state of the school is strong. At this juncture in time, and as we're celebrating 10 years after its naming, USC Viterbi is entering one of the most exciting chapters in our history. Built on over a century of innovation in research and education, we are sharpening our upward trajectory. Planning for this should be based on the intersection of three sets, as Jim Collins says in his book, From Good to Great. First, be what you are deeply passionate about. Second, be what are you best in the world at. Third, marshal the resources to enable this to happen. Deeply passionate about, best in the world, this is the challenge in front of each and every one of us. To be deeply passionate about what we do, and to be the best in the world in what we do. And then raise the resources to enable them. Being deeply passionate about what we do naturally leads to new exciting initiatives without the need for external motivation, because passion brings the proverbial fire in the belly. Being the best in the world in what we do makes us and our colleagues to be joining us in the future by definition transformative. Both this will bring excellence, zero tolerance for mediocrity, and will keep advancing a culture of excellence and creativity to be unmatched anywhere else. To help us reach there, we have embarked on one of our the most ambitious fundraising campaigns ever undertaken by Engineering School. Legendary aerospace engineer and mathematician Theodor von Karman said several decades ago, "Scientists discover the world that exists. Engineers create the world that never was." Creating the world that never was is the theme of our campaign. We aim to raise $500 million to elevate USC Viterbi to greater heights. That's $500 million to those of you who are counting. It is the amount we raised in the last 10 years, but this now will have to be raised in a much shorter time. In the broadest sense, we will invest our donors' gifts to support the four pillars by attracting world-class professors and students, endowing chairs, creating new programs, naming and endowing departments and programs, and building best-in-class facilities to advance research. We will also deepen our strong commitment to innovation and entrepreneurship with the ambition to establish USC Viterbi at the core of a booming and growing ecosystem of entrepreneurship. How are we doing in this campaign so far? To date, and after 4 years since the campaign was launched unofficially, we have raised almost half of it, $250 million. We are halfway there with about the same time to go. But as you know, the latter part is the most difficult part. So far, we have almost 10,000 unique donors that have given almost 20,000 gifts so far in this campaign. 10,000 unique donors have contributed to USC Viterbi's campaign. Mary Ann Schwartz, our Senior Associate Dean for Advancement, and her advancement team are here today. We look forward to partnering with you over the next 4 years to share your stories with our donors and to help our campaign shape the future of our school. So the state of the school is strong and getting stronger. When I started as a dean 9 years ago, I articulated the following vision: to be first at USC, a leader in the nation, constantly rising quality and with excellence in all our endeavors, so that we can all say, I am fortunate to be part of the Viterbi School. This vision remains as strong now as it was then. Thanks to you, the school has scaled unprecedented heights in teaching, research, and innovation, and now attracts the best and brightest talent from anywhere in the world. Each and every one of you has played an important role to help transform USC Viterbi into one of the nation's and the world's finest and most dynamic schools of engineering. I am most grateful for your dedication and commitment. As I close, I am reminded of the book, The Beginning of Infinity, by Oxford quantum physicist David Deutsch. He states, problems, I prefer to say challenges, are inevitable, but all problems are solvable. Indeed, there will always be problems because they represent collisions of ideas and because as you move ahead, the challenges become greater. But I absolutely share in the belief that all problems can be solved, and I invite you to share this mindset. Thank you for listening, and fight on.